Hello there, all you amazing people. We are going to talk. Just give me a second here, just messing with my OBS. So you're still here with this SSD thing here that people have a little bit of a fear that the rewrites thingy that, oh, it only have like a certain amount of rewrites, and then at that point it basically just everything just goes tits up and you can't use it or anything like that. And that's true, but we also have to remember, what is the lifespan of an SSD? How much do you use it? What do you do with it? And stuff like that. Because so the SSD that I just showed you guys and girls, this one here, is an old SSD with old technology. So that means that they don't have all of the read and write protection that a lot of new stuff has. This one, I don't even know, can I see when this was made? Oh yeah, 15th of January 2016. From 2016. It's like an older generation SSD. This works perfectly today. So all of this, read and write problems that they say SSD has, and oh my god, you can only, like I said, read and write to them a certain amount of time, and then all your data get lost and blah blah blah. First of all, you need to have proper backup, okay? Backup anything. Your spinning hard drives also have a certain amount of read write on them, and they have more failure or point failures. But like, it's a mechanical thing. Mechanical things typically fails more than stuff like this because it's mechanical. It's self-explanatory. Things can get, worn out. They can get worn down, and they can stuff like. So I don't know why people are so like, oh my god, be careful of SSD, and then they just put like a crappy hard drive into their system, and then the read-write head at some point fucks up, and they're like, I don't care. I'm used to it. It's a hard drive, so yeah, we live with that. No. Like I said, I got this hard drive. This is from January 2016, and I probably installed Windows 10 on it in, I think it was mid-2016. And it has been running on this Windows installed up till February 2020. Oh, that's not right. 2023. When I updated my computer. It's been running from 2016 non-stop to 2023. No issues. It's running 24/7. Let's clean the screen here. It's been running almost 24. That's a 4/7. It's been upgraded for 4 PCs. Okay? And I upgraded from Windows 10. I got a little bit of a hit of myself there. 10. I'm really bad at drawing here. 2/11 when that came out. It's running 24/7, almost 24/7 since 2016. It's been in 4 PCs, upgraded my PC 4 times. I upgraded from Windows 10 and 11 and no reinstall. No reinstall. It's still 100% functioning. I've run my YouTube channel off this one here. Recording, testing, editing. What I do or usually did was that I run. So if you say this is my SSD, my C drive basically. Then I would have like another cast drive here where I had my files on, they were located and stuff like that. So I had my recording software here. And cast drive here, you get what I'm coming at. Done that since that time. I have no errors on it, it's not acting up. When I do a smart scan, no issues, it's 100% okay. So you do the math. 16 to 23, that's 8. 8 years with my first grade math skills and no issues. So why do I keep this one here? This still have Windows 11 on it. I'm using an NVMe right now. If tits or shit hits the fan, if titties hits the fan, that hurts like a mofo. But if everything goes tits up with my computer right now, or at least my NVMe, I can still plug this into this computer and I can work off it. Because everything I need to do everything in my life is still on this hard drive here. Or this SSD here. Where is all of this fear mongering coming from? Why are a lot of people saying that? Because of the corporate world. That's where you should need to be afraid, because if this is in a server somewhere, you know, you have it laying around in a server. I don't know why this fucks up for me all the time, but just imagine this is a server. This is a server. Wow, that's really bad. That's where you need to be aware of it. You get what I'm saying? The good old server market for corporations. That's where you need to be afraid of it. At home, unless you're doing like a NAS server. You can see my bad handwriting here. You know, a NAS server or something like, or you just have your own server at home. You know, you have your own little server at home. Then you should be a little bit afraid. So if it's a server that runs all the time, that do a lot, like let's say it's backing up maybe half an hour or something like that. Now you should need to be worried. But if you're just at home and you're just, you know, gaming, browsing, whatever you're doing, you know, browsing, porn hopping and what have you not. If you're just doing this thing here down here, you should not be that afraid. It's mostly for people up here that run stuff like this here. You know, that's rewriting almost 24/7. So if you're rewriting like 10 hours a day, 18 hours a day, now you need to think about the rewrite. I hope this makes sense. A lot of people, they tend to read what the experts are saying when they are talking to experts. So they are listening, they're going on to the YouTubes, the forum post, and they are listening to what do someone working in a corporation saying when they are talking to another person working in a server room. Ah, that must be the same as at home. No. Not only is the hardware for servers and in corporations a lot of times different, but the use case is different. You don't run your gaming with you know, your gaming rig or your home computer or your browser computer as a server or as a workstation. So when you hear like it has like, let's say 10, this is a low number, but let's just pretend it's 10,000 read-write cycles. You may never get that. I know we are talking way more than 10,000, but a server will get it really fast, because let's say this on is on 20 hours a day and there's being written files, let's say 1 gigabyte is written to it every 30 minutes, and then people are accessing that data. That's a lot of data going in and out of it. You get what I'm at here? If you trust USB devices, you can trust these things here, because a USB device is just this here with another fucking interface on it. It's the same shit. I hope this makes sense. I hope you learned a little bit today, and I really hope you're the one that's fell over your dick and land your head in a pot of gold, because then throw some of that gold my way, by the way. But yeah, see you all later. Bye-bye.